And welcome to Significant TV, significant stories, significant entrepreneurs. I'm your host, Fran McNeil, and joining me in the studio today is Lisa Kramer. Lisa is an executive coach, and she has reinvented herself several times. She graduated from the University of Pennsylvania, having received her master's in social work at age 23. And so what's so significant is Lisa believes that life is too short to be afraid. And so she helps others lead with intention. Welcome, Lisa, to Significant TV. How are you today?
I'm doing great. It's great to be here with you, Fran.
You know, it's really funny. I mean, years ago, it feels like ages, we worked together with the Wharton Women's MBA program, and we were both coaches kind of doing our thing and sharing our knowledge. A lot's happened since then, right?
A lot.
Wow.
Yes.
Yeah. And back then, I remember you being just very passionate about being a life coach at that time. Take us back to that point in time.
So when I first started my coaching business, I had transitioned from doing clinical social work and teaching social work, and life coaching was really a natural transition. Over the past 10 years or so, I've really transitioned again into more executive and leadership coaching. So right now I'm doing a lot of work inside of organizations and working with leaders at all different levels.
So I hear a common thread. I mean, social work, you're really working with individuals, and a lot of times they may be challenged, mm-hmm. or they may be at that point where they want to overcome a challenge. And then to go into corporate, working with corporate individuals, I imagine there's some built-in challenges in the organization. Tell me a little bit about that, and why is that, you know, sort of energy generating for you?
One of the things that I love about working inside of organizations is helping leaders become coach leaders. So a big emphasis of my work is helping leaders to use the skills of listening and asking good questions in order to develop the people who report to them, and also to really help them to step into their greatness as leaders, because there are a lot of people that are walking around and they're only like half alive. You know, they're not really using all of the skills and all of their gifts. And I think coaching really shines the light on what people are capable of. And that, for me, is very gratifying.
I can understand that. I mean, having been in corporate some time ago, the structure occasionally can suffocate a person, mm-hmm. or at least have them be hesitant about, as you said, bringing out their greatness. So coaching managers and leaders to be better coaches, that seems kind of a new thing. How did you get into that? And why do you specialize there?
So because I taught undergraduate and graduate social work, and I think I'm really a natural born teacher. So as much as I love coaching, I love the teaching and training part. And what I have found is that people who are the recipients of coaching don't necessarily learn how to be great coaches. It doesn't really translate. But going in and teaching them those skills, I just see, you know, just the, you know, the light bulb goes on and they really get it. And it makes such a difference in terms of how they engage with the people who they work with. You know, to sit and really listen and ask questions as opposed to just be telling and giving answers, which, you know, we're all adults. We don't necessarily want people to be giving us answers all the time. And so that's something that they learn how to do, and it makes a big difference.
Mm-hmm. Now, I mentioned earlier that we met when you were doing life coaching. What was a sort of significant story that put you on the path of being an entrepreneur? I mean, graduating from a master's program at age 23, I imagine you had lots of options.
Well, it's interesting. I mean, I do think that our personal lives really influence the direction that we go. And so when I was doing more of the life coaching, I would say I was, you know, more dabbling in coaching, but I wasn't taking myself or the work as seriously as I knew I could. And then in 2008, I ended a 23-year marriage and was a single woman, you know, on my own. And there was something about the experience of going through a divorce that really enabled me to kind of step into my power even more and believe in myself even more and have the confidence that I needed to put myself out there. And so that's what I did. And that journey just took me more into organizations. I think as I was, I know this sounds kind of cliche, but playing big in my own life, I wanted to work with people who were doing that too. And it seemed to just take me into the world of corporate and working in organizations.
So challenges sometimes can lead to opportunities, personally and professionally.
Very much so.
And in working with corporate folks or even with individuals, what's a result or what's an experience where you really knew that you made a difference?
So the client that I've been working with the longest, because it's, you know, typically coaching engagements are maybe 18 months. This client I actually started working with in 2009, and we're still working together. I mean, we've scaled back a bit, but I feel like I've become more of like his trusted leadership advisor. So he's the owner distributor of a company, and the company really has undergone a transformation over the course of the time that he and I have been working together. And there's a variety of factors, but I do believe that the coaching has been a significant one. He has transformed his sales team, just in terms of the revenue that the company is making. But it's not just about the money. Like, the people that work there are genuinely, they're engaged, they love working there, they look forward to going to work in the morning. And I think a big part of it is just how he himself has changed and how that's had a ripple effect throughout the organization. So that's been really exciting for me.
Well, I imagine a lot of people would love to have their leaders transform. Again, I have had those late night conversations with some friends where they're like, I really don't want to go to work. Mm-hmm. So let's just maybe role play a little bit.
Okay.
If I'm a manager and you're brought in to an organization to work with me, what might that sound like, you know, in our first interaction?
So I'd probably ask you the question, if you could fast forward to maybe a year from now and you were able to create the kind of work life that really worked for you. So the work that you were doing and what was happening outside of work really was aligned with who you are and what your values are and that kind of thing. Describe for me what would be happening. So paint me a picture.
Ah, okay. And have you ever faced a time where folks just said, I don't know, Lisa, it's all about work, or I really hate this job, I need it, but really my life is all about my family?
So one of the things that I really do believe that there's a shortage of listening in this world, and there are very few people who have had someone ask them a question and really wait and listen for the response. So I might say something like, I believe that you do have a clearer idea of what you want. And so just take some time and just think about it. You don't have to answer immediately, but just take some time, because I do believe that there's kind of an inner knowing. There's something that you really do know, but maybe you've hesitated to say what that is.
That's powerful.
Yeah, it is. And it's amazing to me what sometimes people have to take it as a homework assignment because they're just overwhelmed with the question. It's like,
oh my goodness.
I need it. But they come back with just such beautiful, beautiful ideas and beautiful visions of what they really want. And then the challenge is they'll say, well, like, how am I ever going to make that happen? And I say, well, that's where you and I are going to work together. It's, let's not focus on the how yet. Let's really stay with the what. And it's very powerful.
It sounds powerful. So in doing this work, and especially in making that transition from living with intention to leading with intention, where do you see yourself transforming and having this significant impact? I mean, I know there was an article written about you recently, so you're you know, well, entering the bigger stage.
Yes, I think that I've reinvented myself three or four times in the course of my 60 plus years on the planet so far. And I just think it never ends, you know, until we take our last breath, it never ends. So I don't know exactly where I'm going next, but I'm always thinking about, like, how can I make my work even more satisfying? And I have some ideas, but nothing super clear quite yet, but I'll definitely keep you posted.
Right. And I'll be here to listen.
Well, I appreciate that.
Your tagline is very powerful, and I was intrigued by that. Can you share that tagline and sort of how you came up with that?
So the tagline is creating coaching cultures. And my vision is to see organizations incorporate coaching throughout the organization. So not that everybody has to be assigned to an external coach who comes in, and that can be extremely expensive for the company, but that people at all levels of the organization are learning how to coach, how to listen, how to ask good questions, how to help people be accountable, how to give feedback, that's just going on, you know, up and down and sideways in the organization. That's my dream.
And that's a powerful dream, because if that happens, or as that happens in an organization, it clearly is a skill and a series of skills that people can use in their outside life. So
for sure,
sort of the circle continues.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, in the training that I do, I tell people coaching skills are life skills. And forget the disclaimer, don't try this at home. I say, go home and use this with your families, use this in your community. They are life skills for sure.
Well, speaking of life skills, what's one significant lesson that you would want to share with another entrepreneur?
It has to do with uncertainty, because being an entrepreneur it's just not for the faint of heart. And there is a lot of uncertainty when you go off on your own. To me, that's incredibly exciting. You know, that the uncertainty can be scary at times, but it also means, like, there are so many possibilities. And I think that as an entrepreneur, if you focus more on what's possible as opposed to going to that fear place, you will absolutely be successful.
Totally agree. Possibilities. Words create worlds. What you think of, what you believe in, it allows you to focus.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, Lisa, it's been a pleasure having you as a guest of Significant TV. Wish you continued success.
Thank you, Fran.
And it's been exciting just to hear your journey of reinvention and the pride and, you know, sort of vision associated with that.
Well, thank you. It's been great being here talking with you.
Significant stories, significant entrepreneurs, Significant TV. Lisa Kramer is principal of Leading with Intention. Continue to watch Significant TV to hear more stories like hers.